I'm Alan Banks, and this is Dr. Isaac Tawil. And we just got done seating a double arch graphite nano case, and it was so exciting that we thought we would document the case from start to finish, because a lot went on in this case. And a lot of it is things that our customers were already doing, but a lot of it is really contemporary, and even these materials, some of these real cutting edge materials. And this is our patient, Victor, who we've been working on for, gosh, like 4 years. He lives in Cleveland, correct, where we are. You're in Brooklyn, mm-hmm, and he insisted on coming to you for every step of it. So he was in that prosthesis for months.
Yes,
9 or 10 months.
Because of COVID, he was in there even longer.
Yeah.
Yep. So he had a long-term C2F prosthetic that lasted about 2.5 years.
Right, right.
But then it was finally time to go to final, and which we did, and we did a really nice job with the final, considering that he had a full denture prior to that, that we converted over, and we based everything off of his full denture.
Right, right.
What we
vertical
didn't know about Victor,
all that, right.
What we didn't know about Victor is that he actually wasn't happy about his full arch denture, and he actually wanted more of a toothy smile for his upper jaw.
Because he really wasn't that demanding at the very beginning.
No, he was just happy to have teeth.
They evolve in their demands, right?
He really just wanted to throw away that full arch denture and get something that he can really chew with that would be comfortable.
Yeah, and he had a lower hybrid with implants,
correct,
when you met him, right?
Correct. So it was actually a friend of mine who introduced me to him, and he couldn't handle the case, and so he wanted, and he did assist us on the surgery, and he watched us do the full arch chrome, and now he's a chrome user.
Right.
For basic chrome cases.
Yeah.
And Victor was a little bit more advanced.
Right.
But he did the lower, and it came out quite nice. But that was several years ago. Now Victor is looking at having a full arch upper, which he's now had existing for about a year. We made it metal free with Procera screws.
Right.
Full arch zirconia.
Right.
And he had a lower full arch zirconia. The first thing that Victor told me when he came in and he had the teeth was how come they click so loud,
right,
which is a common problem with zirconia in our patients. I would say at least 1 out of 10 of the double arches have that clicking sound when that the patient notices. They all have that clicking sound.
Clank, 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 clank. He just kept doing it, and he says people hear him when they're sitting next to him.
Correct.
They hear it at night, and then...
And that's a full arch zirconia problem that's global, that yet we just accept it because that's our only alternative. Zirconia is the standard.
Yeah.
And we went metal-free, which is great, because we got to reduce the heights of the prosthesis if needed. We have the screw access holes are a lot nicer without these tie bases. Mm. I believe that there's a big problem with tie bases and zirconia fracture. And now that we can remove the tie bases, we can remove the metal componentry, we can actually make these prostheses a little bit thinner, which is wonderful, especially on our FP1 cases. But we did use the Procera screws for this. This was earlier, before we switched over. If you look at the lower right, that Victor is missing some teeth there. So what we did was we sectioned the bridge in that area. We took out one implant, we placed two additional implants, and then we let them rest with some multi-unit abutments until he was able to remake the lower, which was about 3 to 4 months later. And you do notice when we look at this scan how we don't see a lot of his upper jaw. We see a lot of his lower jaw, which is typically traditional for most patients. As we age, our muscle structure gets a little bit weaker. So what's the first thing to happen is we get droopiness from the orbicularis oris, and then we start to show more of those lower teeth.
Well, and he's 55, mm-hmm, but he's a denture wearer.
Correct.
So vertical's collapsing,
correct,
getting a little bit of frown. The tooth exposure is going to be different because
absolutely
of a worn out denture.
We don't have that buccal vestibule from that denture holding it back out anymore.
Right.
Which we didn't account for when we made the upper final teeth. So we said, you know what, since we're making the lower over, why not go ahead and remake the upper? This was the opportunity. The problem that we have when doing that is we have to go ahead and remake all scans, go back to new try-ins, and he lives in Cleveland, I live in New York. It's a little bit of a hassle for him to come down. He's more than willing to, but we have technology now that's at our fingertips that we can utilize that's really affordable, surprisingly, that we can utilize to actually shorten the treatment time for these visits.
Here's the crazy part of this whole case. We're going to take a patient who is in double arch zirconia restorations, make new upper and lower, and lower the entire plane of occlusion 4 millimeters, all from facial scans, right? Just to make sure we got this, the teeth within this face. But then we also used on the maxillary, we used photogrammetry records.
At the time, that was all we had at the time to be able to make these records accurate and fast so that we can go to a faster turnaround.
And that, because the first one was we made him a full arch final zirconia to go against
metal free with an ICAM 4D.
Right, to go against the lower existing hybrid to see how that went, and we thought, oh, he's done.
Right.
But surprise. He wants something a little more exciting, a little more youthful for him. So we took all those existing digital records and then we combined them with grammetry records on the lower.
Yeah. All right. All in all, just an amazing experience to be able to do this in just an impression and then go straight to final with such a dramatic transformation as Victor had here. It was life-changing for Victor.
And to learn more about grammetry, photogrammetry, we have a group on Facebook that's dedicated just to that type of modality there for restorations. And it's just type grammetry when you're searching in Facebook and click connect. It's not a private group, you can connect just like that. And of course, as always, follow our content. We have content on Facebook, YouTube. Go to our website, go to the top right, click and follow. We have a ton of content, always learning, always doing cutting edge things.